Today, let's refurbish the screen of iPhone 12. Judging from the appearance, the iPhone 12 has a narrower bezel than the iPhone 11 Pro. So the iPhone 12 bezel may be a little easier to disassemble. In addition to that, the iPhone 12 bezel doesn't wrap around the glass lens anymore. Therefore, the material requirements for the bezel adhesive will be relatively high to prevent the adhesive from falling off. Next, let's check it out by refurbishing the iPhone 12 screen. First of all, let's test the screen. The display, touch, and 3D touch all function well. Place the screen upside down on the screen separator. Set the temperature to 100 degrees Celsius and start the suction. Remove the ear speaker flex cable first. Since the ear speaker flex cable is very easy to damage, please be noted that we need to heat the screen before removing the ear speaker flex cable. Besides, the iPhone 12 ear speaker sensor ring is integrated into the bezel. Now, let's remove the bezel. Dip adhesive remover on the bezel first. While using the razor blade to separate the bezel, you need to dip some adhesive remover too. Slide the razor blade back and forth. Pry out the bezel carefully. As the ear speaker flex cable part has more adhesive, we can dip more adhesive remover to make it loose. Hold the two corners of the bezel in both hands. Detach the bezel slowly with caution. Our original thought was to separate the bezel in a complete manner and then reuse it. But now the bezel is broken here. So please notice that this part of the bezel is made of plastic material, which is extremely easy to break. If you want to separate the bezel completely, you need to pay extra attention. In order not to induce damage, we use a thin film to remove the flex cable part. Remove the bezel. It can be seen that the 3M adhesive used in the bezel flex cable part is no longer the gold adhesive, so it is relatively easy to remove. Remove excess adhesive on the ear speaker flex cable part. Start separating the OLED along the bottom layer of the glass lens with cutting wire. Through our observation, we found that the touch panel of the iPhone 12 screen is better than that of the iPhone 11 Pro, which is not easy to damage. Place the OLED on the heating platform. Roll up the OCA adhesive with the electric adhesive removing tool. Then remove the remaining OCA adhesive. Connect the OLED and ear speaker flex cable. Note: Not connecting the ear speaker flex cable will lead to the absence of light sensing. The screen will be too dark to be tested. Test the display and touch function. All going well. Attach OCA adhesive to the glass lens. Put the glass lens with OCA adhesive into the bubble removing machine for 3 minutes. Then put it into UV lamp for curing OCA glue for 5 seconds. Wipe clean the OLED. Use pull tape to stick a corner of the glass lens. Tear off the protective film of the OCA adhesive. Since the iPhone 12 aligning mold has not come out yet, we use manual alignment. Place the screen on the laminating sponge. Please notice that 2 slots are cut on the sponge in order to prevent OLED damage. Put the screen into the laminating machine. Press LCD Laminate Start. Take out the screen and we can see there are bubbles on the screen. Put the screen back into the bubble removing machine for 10 minutes. Then put the screen into UV lamp for curing OCA glue for 180 seconds. Test the screen. All functions work well. In practice, we found that the iPhone 12 screen was less difficult to refurbish than previous models.